about the religion and society in our early times. So in the previous classes we have been, in the two classes we have, one class we have been get through the introduction of this class, and second in the yesterday's class we have been get through the two subtopics. One was about the hunter gatherers and another was about the farmers and the herders, how they were being the religious aspects. They were worshipping to their deity, to the animals. At the same time, they were also worshipping the trees, plants, or to the mother goddesses, the statue of the clay they used to make, the orals. They used to worship on the stones, plants, trees, even the animals. Even though for the animals they used to hunt, but still they used to worship, they used to believe that whenever there is a need for the animal, they will be hunting up. And other than that, one, they used to pray for the animals, and at the same time they considered the sacred, whereas for the plants, whereas for the trees. And hunter gatherers, they used to hunt animals, they used to paint their caves, the living places, with the help of their dancing uniform or animals' skins. They used to wear like a mask, like they will be using to do the recreation. So in today's class of so we are going to have to build the religion in the Indus Valley civilization, that is of page number 145. So this religion, the third subtopic, it is about religion. Where first two, it was of hunter gatherers, and the second was about the farmers and the herders, how they religious ideas in different states they used to call by the different names. So all we have in job. Now we are going to have a civilization changing. So where the civilization has been changed, the different aspects is Indus Valley civilization. This is a very important of topic. Indus Valley civilization. Civilization, it deals, it means the changing in the living side or the upgrading, how they are being going to deal up. So this has been existing in which place, mostly here by the word, you can understand river Indus. River Indus in the northern part of India. So nearly they have been 4,600 years before. And how many this for how many years it has been lasted? Last time it was been existed up to the 900 years. So at the same time, this Indus Valley civilization is also being considered as a Harappan culture. Harappan civilization or Harappan culture is also being considered. Either the Indus Valley civilization or the Harappan culture. So it is been which river is by the river of Indus, nearly how many years before? 4,600 years before. And for how many years it has been existed? It has been existed for nearly 900 years. So several cities emerged in the northwestern parts of the subcontinent in the plains of the Indus River some 4,600 years ago. So where it is existing in which place of India is north part? So river Indus has been existing in the north direction, north part of India. So direction in the north part of India, it has been existed. And to which place river is, definitely it will be on the plains. Indus Valley civilization near to the plain areas where the fertile land will be there for growing the agriculture and crops. The people can be without any problem. So these cities lasted for nearly 900 years and then declined. So declined means slowly with the help of floods or earthquakes, natural calamities, and at the same time the people were moving from one place to another place. Due to that, the city has been declined after 900 years of this Indus Valley civilization. And this Indus Valley civilization, it is also been known as the Harappan culture. So this is also called Harappan culture after Harappa, who was excavated first by the archaeologists. So why it is known as the Harappan culture is, this is the first Indus Valley civilization who has been, how we get to know is the person archaeologist called Harappa. Through this excavations finding out, so it was been dedicated to that archaeological person. So what these cities, this archaeological people has been finding out is, they are finding out different kinds of people that was been living in this Indus Valley civilization. Who were those copper spent massive spaces on the roof. So these kind of people, they were existed in this Harappan culture of Indus Valley civilization. So among them, what are the things that has been found by the archaeological people are ruins with the leftover part, the leftover the grocery vessels, pots that has been found out, the bath, granaries, storehouses, public buildings, road, trains, houses of ordinary people were found. However, until now, no big temple or temple was found. Several mother goddesses figure were found. It also seems that they held several trees, including the people, as sacred and also probably worship some animals. Pictures of the maid and gods were also found. So these things that has been found by the archaeological people, the leftover, like in the history class, have been shown the figures 17.4, then 17.6. So likewise, the mother goddesses, idols, they have been found out. The worshipping of the animals, their pictures on the places, not complete the houses or the pots, only the leftover, like broken pieces, how it will be. So that type of below the underground, it has been found out by these archaeological people. But they did not find any big temple or any religious spaces where, like presently, how the religious spaces have been existed. Only the plants, leaves, animal paintings, all these have been found out in these places. So next in the figure, page 146, you can find out the figure of the male god from the Harappa, then next the mother goddesses of Harappan culture. So now, how we been worshipping this? They used to worship either by the paintings or either by the mother goddesses figure. They used to make and they used to worship her. This may be god similar to Shiva worship in later times in various parts of India. From other picture, it seems that the people of Indus took on processions carrying banners in honor of their gods during festival times. So what they did during any kind of celebrations or any kind of if they got huge feasts, like animal they have been hunted, they got the good crop. So at that time they used to celebrate. Not only that, one of the religious occasions, they if they want to celebrate to the the religious deities, their festivals, their birth or marriages, all this one, they all group together, they will form and all they will be going to take on the processions, rallies, so like was they used to celebrate. So later part, what was the main god they used to worship is, it was a presently as changing all the times, they used to worship the Lord Shiva. And mother goddesses is the female deity, the people, how they will be worshipping. Now coming to the second, the fourth subtopic, it is about the religion of Vedas. Religion of Vedas. So Vedas are nothing but it is being considered as a literature. So literature part means the writing part, how the religion aspect, according to that, how society is being treated. Literature, and among these Vedas, there are four types of Vedas. In the introduction, I have been saying of synopsis. First is Rig Veda, second is Yajur Veda, third is Sama Veda, and the last is Atharvana Veda. So we go in detail about these Vedas, how they are being worshipped, to what all the different aspects, to whom it is being dedicated, how much old it is, which is a new one. For all these four Vedas deals with what, how the people they used to worship these particular Vedas are being related to the people. The Vedas are the early surviving literature of the Indian subcontinent. There are four Vedas. First, Rig Veda, the Yajur Veda, Sama Veda and Atharvana Veda. Of these, Rig Veda was the oldest and composed about some 3,500 years ago. So among these four Veda, completely this about me, I am going to deal about the India and Indian subcontinent, completely the subcontinent of Asia. So now Vedas, four Vedas, Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda and Atharvana Veda. So out of these Vedas, the very oldest is Rig Veda. It was been composed nearly 3,500 years ago. The oldest it consists of the praising of the various gods or the goddesses, like shlokas or religious songs or religious stories. So like this, it is being deals with this Vedas. So important of these in this Vedas, to which god or goddesses they have been gave importance here, is these hymns were in praise of various gods and goddesses. Three gods were specially important. First is Agni, the god of fire, Indra, Varian god, and so many times from which a special drink was prepared. Priests taught students to recite and memorize each syllable, word, sentence bit by bit with great care. Most of the hymns were composed, taught, and learned by men. A few were composed by women. The hymns were recited mainly during the performance of yajnas or rituals during which offerings were made to the fire. So when this all these Vedas are nothing but the literature part about the praising of god and goddesses, especially for what purpose is for the welfare of the people. And when these Vedas or these things will be recited, is whenever any religious act like doing of the yajnas, like firework, you'll be doing that is not in your home, we are be doing on yajnas, then any kind of religious rituals. So these priests, rishis, they'll be read out this one, and in this way they'll be doing this Vedas. And who will be teaching this Vedas to the children is this rishis and munis, like brahmins, purohits, priests, persons. They'll teach this Vedas, shlokas, this hymns to the person, to the children, like bit by bit, sentence by sentence, with a great care. Like you will be going like Bhagavad Gita classes, all this is done. So likewise they will use to teach the children. So mostly who will be read, who will go with this one is only the male child, not women. Women, but only very few in detail will see. So like one, they have been given on to one of the prayer to the god, how they will be dealing them. Ashtama Sadhyama Asoma Jyoti Ramaya Mitraya Mantra Gangama Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. So what is the meaning is, for ignorance, from ignorance, lead me to truth, from darkness, lead me to light, from death, lead me to immortality, O peace, peace, peace. So what it means is, the person who, for the welfare of people, this one, from ignorance, means I don't know anything. So from that ignorance, make me to live, to know the truth, from not knowing to knowing. Second one, from darkness, what he has been suffering, any kind, from darkness to light, and from death to the immortality, like two words to the V-spirit. So like this, of it is in existence, then completely it will be existing of the peace. Now second conversation, it is between Vishwamitra and the rivers. So Vishwamitra, he has been saying, having conversation with the rivers, when he has been crossing on the river, what problem he has been facing. O rivers, come down from the mountains like two swift horses, white horses, like two shining cows that lick their claws. You move like chariots to the sea, know the power of Indra. You are full of water and wish to unite with one other. Then the reward was, we who are full of water move along the path the God have made for us. Once we start flowing, we cannot be stopped. Why do you pray to us, O sage? Vishwamitra, O sisters, please listen to me. The singer who has come from a distance with his chariots and chants, let your water to rise, not rise above your axes, so that we can cross safely the rivers. We will listen to your prayers so that we can cross safely. So this Vishwamitra, we need to cross the river, but above the chariots, the wheel, if the water arises, then automatically it will going to dip into the river. So he is praying to the river that above the axle of the wheel, the water, you don't rise your water. You don't rise the flow of the water. But the river is what we have been saying, the path which the God has created, we need to go along to that path, and why you have been praying to us. So Vishwamitra has said, if you move, the water rises above the chariot, the axle wheel, then it will be going to get dripped, so it might be causing the loss. So but still this river has been listened to the prayers of the Vishwamitra. So like this, prayer to the rivers, prayer to the God, prayer to the God, what is his deities. So in this way, this hymns, this the ladies, these Vedas are being kept recited. So especially in this Rig Veda, they will pray for the cattle and pray for the children and the children. river. So likewise, these people, they have been lived in the Indus Valley civilization near to the northern parts of India, near the Hindu Kush means in the Himalaya mountains, and the Yamuna river flowing to the northern parts of the India. So this is the inhabited settlement of these people, especially in the Rig Veda. And this Rig Veda people, they used to have been caring of the animals of cows and horses. So these Vedic people lived in a small, in a group they used to be, and they have their own leader, and the person who was doing all this yagnas, they used to call him as a Brahmins. And what they will be doing in return to this Brahmins, they used to give the gifts to the leader.